Hi guys, I'm going to be doing a first impressions video today and I'm going to be testing out the Ordinary Serum Foundation. I ordered this off Beauty Bay and I'm quite excited to get right into it. It has some very good reviews. It also has quite a good shade range. It has 21 shades and these range from very fair to very deep. And they have three types of undertones for each one. So they have neutral, pink or yellow undertones. I've picked up shade 1.0N. So this is the very fair neutral shade. This is the palest shade that they have. And we all know my strife for trying to find foundations that are in my shade. And so hopefully this one will match my skin. I have already gone ahead and primed my skin with the Max Factor Facefinity Primer, and so let's get right on into the video. I'm opening up the carton. You get 1 fluid ounce, so you don't get that much, but it's quite good. And this is what it looks like. It's in a little kind of pump bottle, which is always handy. Okay, so let's pump some onto the back of our hand. First impressions, it's very runny, but that's to be expected from a serum foundation. Okay, I'm just going to dot this onto my face in kind of the usual manner. I'm wondering what the ingredients for this are. Okay, so this is going on very silkily. It does have dimethicone in it, but it doesn't seem to have any parabens. I might be wrong, I'm just checking the box. Yeah, it doesn't have any parabens, so that's good for your skin. The Ordinary is quite a good skincare brand as well. I really want to try out their rosehip oil facial oil thing. Okay, that should do for now. I'm just going to take my Primark Kabuki brush and blend that into my skin. I am obviously not expecting a full coverage foundation. This is a serum foundation. They do have a coverage foundation, but that has much worse reviews and they never ever stock my shade in it. This shade match is really good. I'm hoping you can see kind of the colour of my neck to my face is pretty much bang on, but I don't know if that's because the foundation matches or if that's just because it's quite a sheer foundation. I'm going to try and build it up a little bit more and see how we go. So I'm doing some more pumps onto the back of my hand and I'm just going to dot this onto my forehead, kind of on my cheeks, anywhere that I have kind of discoloration. So I have quite pink cheeks, I might have a rosacea or something. It isn't drying at all, which is always really nice. Okay, so my first impressions are it is a really good colour match. It's not very tacky. I was expecting it to be a lot more dewy. I'm not displeased by the finish of it at all. It's just slightly more matte than I was expecting, but not so matte that it's uncomfortable. So it's always really good for people with dry skin or oily skin. I have quite dry skin at the moment because it's winter. It hasn't done an amazing job of covering up my blemishes, but I wasn't expecting that. It has evened out my skin tone a lot, especially down here, but it still retains some kind of natural skin-like feel, which is really good. I'm going to go ahead and set this, and I'll be right back. Okay, so I set that with a little bit of powder, and it's really comfortable on my skin. I really like it. I think that the shade match is pretty much spot on for my skin tone. I would love to hear what some of you guys' experience of it are. I think this is definitely a thumbs up and I will be using this foundation a lot. I've really enjoyed it and I'm going to do the rest of my makeup, but have a lovely day, and I'll see you really soon with some fun videos.